sand. It's coarse and rough and irritating. It gets everywhere. My mother died in the sand.
We used to go on school trips here. We used to swim together.
I had the opportunity to pursue my acting career. Sarah got to be Padme.
I was Padme in my Star Wars scene.
Yeah, we definitely reenacted the wedding scene in public in front of people, and people watched, and I'm not ashamed. It was amazing. I hope it makes it in. Good night stress, see you in the morning. I don't gotta guess, you're always there for me. So I never see to doubt. I think you like seeing me freak out. Good night stress, see you in the morning. So I wake up, I get out of bed, stay up, stay out of my head, cause it's dangerous. And I don't wanna lose my mind.
Where are we going?
We're going to Star Wars.
We're going to go see the Star Wars where Padme and Anakin got.
I'm reenacting it.
No,
I want to be
as Anakin.
I'm going to be Padme.
Padme.
It's not Padme.
It's Padme.
And
okay. I'm very big into Star Wars, and growing up a Star Wars fan my whole life, I knew that the Anakin Padme wedding scene was filmed there.
Well, for one, I'm not going to miss waking up at 5, but I will miss the traveling and somewhat being with all the students and everyone.
Justin.
Ciao, Giulietta.
Okay, just put on a white t-shirt and I have a tiny little thing.
And then you're Fred. Literally, look, it's Fred and Daphne.
Are you gonna go as Fred for Halloween?
It's not gonna happen. Not gonna happen.
I think Sarah wants to go as Fred and Daphne.
What's bad about that?
So. Fred just sucks.
Yes, if Will would agreed to dressing as Fred for Halloween, I would dress as Daphne. But it would also be fun if everybody else had a character too.
There's no way in hell I'm gonna be Fred from Scooby-Doo. Sarah thinks it's gonna happen, but I told her that there's better options, such as Batman and Robin, or possibly I dress up as like a leg, and then she's gonna dress up as a wart, and then I'm gonna put her in a little baby carriage, and so she'll be a wart on a leg. But ain't no way I'm gonna be Fred.
Welcome to Como, but we are hillside of Como. We'll start up here, so then we're going back down to the lakeside. And we'll...
I was greatly disappointed with Como on our first day with the fascist architecture that we saw. I get that we had to see it, but it was also just like gray.
Our first day in Como, matching the gloriously bleak and grim fascist architecture, the weather was bleak and grim.
It was supposed to be raining and it was not, so we all dressed for the rain with our little light rain jackets on, but then it was freezing, which wasn't supposed to happen either, and we saw fascist architecture
by Giuseppe Terrani. I was actually like worried that I wasn't gonna like Como in general.
I did not enjoy the windmill-themed buildings in Como after this entire semester. My soul transcends to the urban plane.
With 16 eyes and, you know, little clips in his hair. It was a great time. There was also architecture. Right? Something's looking better, baby. Just pass it through.
And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touch.
The buildings really fit the atmosphere, that's for damn sure.
Tarani was my age when he designed this.
Beautiful. Yeah, this is, and also the stone that, or whatever that is on the outside, is just ugly.
I don't like how it doesn't work with the building.
I don't like him.
She loves me.
Look, the shoes, the pants, the shirts, the faces, it's all the same. Just pass it through.
We thought we were 608, but we're actually 408.
Room reveal.
All right. Whew. Hey, we got a TV.
Austin Kinzer and I, we've grown fond of staying in hotel rooms with each other. We're kind of like a threesome in a way.
We all three try to go to bed at the same time. We usually go out to dinner with all the guys.
It's been great. I feel like we all get along very well and enjoy each other's company, but it's sad to see it go.
Today we're going to the famous villa from the Star Wars prequels where Anakin and Padme live.
And they fell in love.
And there's this famous scene where Anakin says he hates sand.
It's coarse and rough and irritating.
Yeah.
And it gets everywhere.
What do you think of the Star Wars prequels?
Why are we talking about Star Wars?
Because the villa we're going today was shot. Like, it was fun. They filmed there for Star Wars.
There's a lot of cosplay potential in this group.
Ryan has cosplayed.
I mean, there's some pretty twisted tickets in this group. I mean, cosplay.
Twisted tickets?
What does that mean?
I'm glad it was an overnight trip, just because we could like spend more time on our last day trip together.
And the sun was shining. There was hardly a cloud in the sky. It was like perfect weather, like 65 degrees.
Exactly what I expected Como to be, and so much more. It was definitely one of the prettiest places I've seen this entire experience.
Going to the Villa Balbinello was so much cooler.
Was amazing, and I feel like I understand the hype around Lake Como and that part of Italy. So it was a lot of fun. I felt like it was a really good trip to end on.
Really enjoyed that second day a whole lot more, and it was just much more relaxing and more to my expectations of how Lake Como was going to be.
Everything was so beautiful. I think it's like the prettiest place I've ever been.
It's not picturesque, it's cinematic.
Okay, I'm going for picturesque. You can have fun.
Alright.
Second Star Wars place we've been on this trip when I didn't think I'd get one in, so that's pretty amazing. I feel like 80% of people there were just there because it was a Star Wars villa. You saw people doing like the Anakin like gaze out with their arms behind their back. I think there was even a wedding recreation.
Thinking, oh my gosh, Natalie Portman and Hayden Christensen walked here. I was shook. I was in love with Anakin as a child, so you know, that was kind of like a very fulfilling moment for me.
Thank you.
painting. It was quite a difficult technique because on glass you have to work backwards, on reverse.
It was beautiful. I liked it. It felt like kind of strange that he was... I felt like there was this like gorgeous Italian villa, and then you like go inside and he's like explorer, like in the North Pole. And so I felt like that was a little just funny because they were like so different, but.
Okay, here we go.
After we got back from Villa Balbianello, Giuditta said, well, we have 2 hours left. Anyone want to take the funicular up to the top of the mountain over there? It's a good view. And me, Lucas, Emily, Steph, Sarah, and Jess said, sure, why not?
We had, you know, a few hours in the afternoon before a train, you know, came back to Milan and then Genoa. And we kind of split up, you know, each person had the option, but, you know, you had to meet back at the hotel to get your bags and go to the train station before the train left at, like, was it 6:10, I want to say?
I think we had multiple issues at the train station in Como. A little bit of a fiasco with Julia and buying an expensive swimsuit and almost not making it to the train. But then we had a group who went to the funicular, and...
I wonder where the others are right now.
Go!
We all went up to the funicular that went to the top of this, like, mountain that's by Lake Como, so you can see all of the city of Como, and you can see out, like, all the way to Milan. But then it was so packed at the top with people trying to go down that we didn't get on it until the 5:45 funicular, and we had 15 minutes to make a 20-minute walk until our train left. And so we were running. We ran the entire length of the city of Como. And me and Juju, we were struggling.
We were booking it. I mean, Sarah was gone. Sarah was like Forrest Gump.
Hashtag not worth it. I would have not done the funicular. I hate running.
Juju was yelling at the cops to stop traffic for us because we're gonna be late. So we're sprinting through all these piazzas. These people are just, you know, sipping their spritzes. All of a sudden we're just zooming by. They're probably like, who the heck are these people? And then it was like Rocky running up the steps to the train station.
We're flying past these tourists, like we're racing each other. This old Italian man overhears us say that our train is at 6:10, and he goes, you'll never make it. But we made it. We made it. We made it to the train.
It was crazy, but it was definitely a good story.
They made it.
Did you guys run?
Yes.
Dang it.
Mockingbird, can't you see? You made it.
We made it.
Judy never misses a train.
Yeah. Not yet.
But she made it. She did a good job. I'm proud of her. I don't think she could ever do that again. I mean, probably 5 more minutes of that, and we'd be having it in memoriam right now for Judy. But she would not have made it.
I didn't want it to start today. Which counts?
Records.
What? Records.
Records, yeah.
Which ones?
Tom Petty. Tom Petty. Sean wants something chaotic to happen. Back in Genoa.
I probably would have just gone back to the States and been like, fuck.
Welcome to the Mercato Orientale, where dreams come true. Happy birthday, Ryan.
Thank you, Austin.
Buon compleanno. This is one of our several trips to Mercato Orientale this semester. A food court that has something for everyone. Even people like Kelsey.
You don't like that? Dude, that is amazing.
They just use a film thing that sticks on your leg?
Yeah.
Oh, that's my
God. It was kind of a spur of the moment thing in terms of getting it. Well, I've wanted it for a while. I made it myself in Photoshop, but I called a place and they said, hey, come in the next hour and we'll fit you in, so.
We're watching Seven Samurai.
Wait, was there is it? Oh, what?
What happened?
Crossed out last week's kitchen assistants because I knew that I was next.
Oh, nice. Julia and Brooke are on it.
Part of me wishes we were going to have this weekend, not in the case of.
We can go ahead and just.
Kitchen duty is probably the most involved of the chores in the villa, and I would say I hear that enough from the other person who does kitchen duty with me.
It's grind time in studio.
Is that your idea?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I don't know if I can give you a right suggestion of it, but what if the color of the existing arrives at the beginning and that's the color of the staff?
Okay.
So continue the path.
I don't know, because it seems that it's a way to deny the relationship with the context.
That's something that has to be laid on in Photoshop.
Yeah, or I just need to find a texture that is like tiled, which is possible.
Okay.
I just need to find
whatever we decide for the actual render, we'll apply it to this.
There was some difficulty finding like plant species on
Inkscape.
These past couple weeks where we've had all these drawings due for our final, it's been getting up early, doing work, having lunch, going to studio, and then having dinner, and then doing more work. And that is just every day.
All right, good. Thanks, Phil.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, now what?
Scream at me like a pterodactyl or something.
Catherine, comfort you? Yeah, Catherine has been playing the ukulele a lot recently.
Probably I think it's getting in the way for people, by
no, time. I think it's a nice coping mechanism.
Yeah, it's keeping me sane because it's hard to be depressed when you have a ukulele.
It's a comedic instrument.
Still a little depressed, but it's helping.
Great.
What are you most looking forward to getting back to in the States?
My bed, my car. My bathroom. My own, like, personal space, I think. And I definitely miss my family and my friends. Yeah.
I am looking forward to my queen-size bed in a room that is my own. And I know I have no room to complain because I'm in the only two-person room except for you and Will. Except for Austin and Will. But
I'm also very excited for Mexican food.
Dr. Pepper. So much.
I'm really looking forward to seeing my family.
I miss my family so much. I miss them so much. When are you leaving?
Sunday, the 30th of April.
You leave in 10 days?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
It's almost over.
Holy shit.
I think my family. I think it's going to be nice to see them again, and it's been a long time.
Made a bark of my soul. I've been singing stories to the crowd. It's been a while since I've been home. I think about you every night. Wonder what it would have been like if I stuck around and settled down, maybe in another life. So if I fly too far, will I still have a place inside your heart?
I think a lot of people are like, oh, I'm so excited to go home, and I could probably like stay here forever. I don't know. I think I'm gonna miss all of the beautiful scenery and obviously the architecture and, I don't know, just the way of life.
I know it's hard when I'm away. I just hope you don't lose faith.
All right, final question.
Cause I told the truth when I said to you that I'll be back someday. So if I